Twinks is pretty good. I haven't played Parappa the Rapper, but I love the artwork. I'm not that good in rhythm games, despite my desires to be a jazz drummer in the future, or at least do some post-punk stuff. Stephen Morris in it. Honestly, I didn't even know his name until I looked it up. He's the Joy Division drummer. I don't own a Hummer. I don't like rape porn, it makes me uncomfortable. I just made a thread on R9K with a picture of a cat in it. That's the only post I ever made on R9K. I used to lurk a year ago, but stopped because I didn't care enough. It looks okay right now, but that's probably because it's 3 AM. I am an incel, and I love to pop my pussy. I don't have a foot fetish, but everybody thinks I do. Sometimes I read Jill Deleuze because some of my friends do, and I've been meaning to read some more books on philosophy for a while. Although every time I do, I have to read every sentence 8 times to fully comprehend what I'm reading. It's kind of frustrating, but I'm okay with it really. Reading makes me happy, but I don't do it as often as I should. Could you recommend me a few of your books? The only thing I've read recently is the lyric sheet for The Velvet Underground and Nico, which is one of my favorite albums of all time. It's a perfect portrait of the drug-induced lifestyles of New York City in the 60s, which is an era of American history that piques my interest, especially in literature and poetry. Sometimes I feel insecure about using big words because I don't want to come off as pretentious. Whenever someone teaches me something about a topic I love, such as art history, I respect them because learning makes me happy. And the more I think about it, I think that's where all my happiness stems from. Proving myself as an artist and a person puts a smile on my face. Pussy bitch Zac Efron. The original recording of Twin Fantasies is the definitive version of the album. And it makes me sad when people like the other version more, but I guess I can understand it. But it's interesting how much raw emotion can be taken away simply from the style which the music was recorded in being changed. From a gay emo furry Daniel Johnson to the Strokes. And I don't even like the Strokes that much, so that explains a bit. I've been called based by at least 4 people in YouTube comments. I hope Earl Sweatshirt's doing okay. I accidentally found a PDF of a yearbook from the late 70s while researching the stabbing of LeJean Etheridge. My French is getting really bad, but it's not like I knew that much in the first place. I consider myself an expert on chocolate milk, but not chocolate itself. Justin Trudeau is a brony. Why was Limp Bizkit ever famous? Kirby is a really good game with good game design. I want to rewatch K-On! One day, but first I want to learn guitar. Ray William Johnson still has me blocked on all the social media. I want to put a line about sissy hypno here, but I don't know how to make it clever. Why is Obama funny? Cheap Japanese adult videos have higher production than the average Nostalgia Critic video. I don't know who Aaron Hernandez is, but apparently he killed people. I haven't played Team Fortress 2 in 4 years. I want to push Hatsune Miku into a pool. I just saw a picture of a cat eating pancakes, and it's really cute. Pancakes in general are funny-looking pieces of food that are really fluffy and taste really good, especially with syrup. Russia is really big, and I don't know why. I have at least 30 tabs of Yuri opened right now while I'm recording this because I like anime lesbians. I don't know why some of the nicest people I've met in my life happen to be furries. There's not enough rap songs that mention Fudanari. A lot of people I know are really cute and I want to hug them. I have a picture downloaded of Xi Jinping's Black membership, and it makes me laugh a lot. ever seen a Nichijou where the girl says domestic violence caught me off guard when I first saw it and it made me burst out laughing cause I'm a dumbass. People that describe their own music tastes as obscure make me mad, but not as much as white kids that listen to Travis Scott. I'm generally hateful towards people whose personality revolves around the music they listen to. I'm working on that because it takes too much of my energy away. I don't like My Chemical Romance. Junji Ito is a good visual artist, but he sucks shit at storytelling. I hate Rager Music's user base with a burning passion. Keep Your Hands Off Asakin has a good opening. I've watched Yuyushiki 3 times. I want to learn Japanese one day, but I know a lot of people will assume it's so I can understand anime. Honestly, I'm just interested in Japanese poetry and writing because I did a report for class a year ago on literature from Asia. And based on descriptions of the English translations, the books I found do catch my eye. I could read the English translations, but whenever I do the same for a book that's originally in Spanish, I feel more enriched in the original Spanish writing. There are some phrases and words that don't translate too well, and the noticeable attempts to disrupt my concentration. Banana Yoshimoto is one that caught my attention. I've only read the translations of Kitchen and part of Goodbye Tsugumi. I didn't get time to read it all because I had to return it to the library and I was too lazy to renew it because I was busy with schoolwork at the time. Kitchen has one of my favorite representations of transgender struggles in media. I refuse to read Haruki Murakami because I'm not a hipster. I have a picture of Tom Waits on my computer saved as bigchungus.png. I like researching frogs whenever I'm feeling down. I watched The Lighthouse a week ago and it's really good. I've been watching movies more often for some reason. I really like Peter Jackson's World War I documentary from 2018. Infrared. Yeah. You know what I mean? Infrared. I just owned a drumpf.